Welcome to World Cinema Reviews. This is your host Frank the Vamp, and hey, I want to talk about Hammer Horror today. I apologize, I'm still under the weather. I'm laying down, so I want it to be as comfortable as possible to make this video. I have my bloodstone here, my beautiful, you know, covey red pillow that I always have here. So I'm comfortable and I'm ready to talk. Ready to talk about Dracula. If you're in the UK, if you were in the US, then it's The Horror of Dracula. Well, this is probably one of the best, if not the best, Christopher Lee Dracula movie. It's the original one, and it just completely kicks ass. This is the beginning of a project where I'm going to try to chronologically review every Hammer, and I may even do non-Hammer Christopher Lee, because I already done one. If you look to the, I think it's called Count Dracula 1970, I can't remember, but you know, more on that later. But for now, we're going to call it The Horror of Dracula. And the title was changed because they didn't want to confuse in America with the 1931 version from Bela Lugosi. So, Dracula was made in 1958, directed by the awesome Terence Fisher, and starring the one and only Christopher Lee as Count Dracula, Peter Cushing as Abraham Van Helsing, Michael Gu as Andrew Holwood, Melissa Simmons as Mina Harker, Carol Mash as Lucy Weather, and John Van Eisen as Jonathan Harker. So, let me just describe the plot to you. There have been, I can't say how many, but there have been tons of Dracula movies, you know, the origin story, you know, where, you know, directed by many different people. The book from Bram Stoker, you know, it's been modified so many times, and there's different variations of it. I really, really enjoyed this variation. So basically, Jonathan Harker arrives as a librarian in Castle Dracula, you know, supposedly, but he's got ulterior motives. You know, he meets you know, Count Dracula, and you know, but when he's in his room all alone, he's kind of writing in his diary that he's really a vampire hunter, and he's been trained by Van Helsing, and he wants to kill Count Dracula. However, there's this young, beautiful temptress lady that sneaks into his room and says she needs to be saved, but she won't say why, or why, or what is Dracula doing to her. But you know, she kind of seduces him, and unfortunately, Mr. Harker, rather than defending himself, kind of lets his guard down, and she bites him. Count Dracula walks in at that moment, gets pissed, and sends her away. But you know, he senses that he's already cursed. Next morning, still being a human, wakes up and attempts to destroy Dracula, but makes a mistake of destroying the woman first. So she stakes her, and then when he's about to stake Dracula, Dracula is the wiser, and he meets his doom. Having left behind his wife Lucy's, Lucy's picture, Count Dracula vows for revenge, goes after Lucy. Now, Peter Cushing, Van Helsing, you know, goes to Castle Dracula and unfortunately finds that Jonathan has failed and has become a vampire himself. So So he needs to finish him off. And the plot basically goes into trying to defend Lucy from becoming a vampire first, and then defend Mina. And there's a lot of similarities and differences here. There's no Rainfield on this version, but I really like it. The movie's fast-paced. The acting is superb. The ending is just what you expect, so classical. The battle between Peter Cushing and Dracula. I mean, this is the script, the writing, the acting. Christopher Lee is just so scary as Dracula. I mean, oh my God. I mean, it's been, let me see, 40. Oh my God, that was made in 1958, so. It's almost 60 years of that film. It's like 57 years that film was made. It's unbelievable, and the fact that it's still great and it's still scary. I can only say that this, to me, it's the best Dracula film. It has so many cool things on it. I mean, it's conservative, but it's also gory. I mean, it shows blood, it shows the bite marks, it shows it shows the great castle Dracula. The production values were pretty good for 1958. I mean, like I said, I just can't say enough about the professionalism and the acting abilities of Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee. Just awesome. So to sum it all up, I mean, I can really, really, really recommend The Horror of Dracula. And I definitely gonna give it a grade of an A. This is great. This is awesome. If you have never seen Hammer Horror, this is a great beginning. Just to let you know though, most Hammer Horror, it's gonna get gorier, it's gonna get more, there's gonna be more skin reveal as time goes on. But I like where it began. I like where it began. It's gothic, Victorian, darker, risque, bloodier. I love the devices that Van Helsing uses. Love Peter Cushing as Van Helsing. I was hoping that he would, always, in every movie, he would always appear, but because of money, budget constraints and time scheduling and other things that happened that couldn't happen, which takes me to the next film, that the next film on the series, which is gonna be Dracula, Prince of Darkness, which was done later, but that's for the next video. So you guys enjoy. If you enjoy, my movie reviews, please, subscribe, leave comments if you like the video, or even if you didn't, I want to hear about it. Be blessed, stay cool, and stay tuned for a lot more Hammer videos and a lot more videos in my channel. Take care, be blessed, and be scared of Christopher Lee, man. He's the real deal.